case. I'm not sure exactly where I left off, but basically with that whole argument that he never really wanted the threesome, I'm making it a bigger deal than it needs to be, and yeah, I shouldn't really bother him with the specifics until I know for sure that, you know, somebody's interested. Okay, once again, I kind of smoothed this over. I don't want to argue. I never wanted to argue, so that's fine. And I ended up being, you know, stupid and me. I ended up going over to his place again that night, and whatever. Again, I had a good time. Like, when we're in person, things generally were good. We didn't fight so much. It was generally just through text, and it was always about the damn threesome that he was obsessed with, even though he's gonna make it sound like he wasn't obsessed with it, and, you know, I was just reading into it, or I don't know. But yeah, I saw him that night. This was like the beginning of November, and again, that whole argument we had, that was because I brought him details when I wasn't sure if she was interested yet. And he hit me up shortly after that to ask again if I found anybody else for a threesome. And I was like, well, you know, I matched with somebody. She looks promising, but I wasn't going to mention anything. I didn't want to mention anything to you because I don't know yet. And to me, he made it clear not to bother him with it until I know or I don't know. So, and this whole argument, I had a lot of trouble making sense of it at the time. It got turned around to where I felt like I was in the wrong and I did apologize, but, you know, reading back on all this now, after the fact, I don't know. I don't know if I was in the wrong. I don't think I was, to be honest with you. And, you know, he's asking me questions about her, and I hadn't met her at this point. Like, I didn't know that much about her. She seemed from a profile like she would possibly be somebody that would be interested in this. And, you know, we were talking, I sent him pictures of her. He thought she was pretty, and then, I don't know. He asked me if she was into guys too. And, like, at that moment, off the top of my head, I couldn't remember. I couldn't remember what her profile said in terms of her sexuality. So I didn't know. So I'm like, I don't know. Let me go look. And that's, again, when, like, a flip switched. Like, never mind. Like, clearly you just want her to yourself if you're not even sure if she's into guys before you're, like, meeting with her. Like, why are you mad at me? Like, I didn't even bring her up to you. I was gonna talk to her and see if it was a possibility, but, you know, he rescinded, I guess, the offer he was gonna make for me to come over and have drinks with him because when he asked me, I wasn't sure about her sexuality. Okay, I don't know. This whole argument and passive aggressiveness, just so bad. Just every single one. And I ended up once again apologizing for everything, and I misunderstood him. And reading back on it, I don't think I did misunderstand him, to be honest. Like, no, he was being the way he always was whenever he didn't get his way or things weren't going as fast or the way that he expected them to, or I didn't act the way that he wanted me to. But again, I did. I apologized to him. I don't know. But yeah. I apologized, and he asked, yeah, do you still want to come over? He wanted me to come over that night, and that night I didn't want to go over. I didn't feel that good, first of all, and then after that whole argument, I was crying, and I felt even worse, so I really didn't want to go over. So I told him that, and he was at this point like, oh, that's too bad, because I'm going to be really busy, probably till, like, March or April. Okay, well, keep in mind, this conversation was happening, like, at the end of November, so it's, like, 4 or 5 months, and he's like, well, I'll see you around. I'm like, well, that sucks, and I was sad about that, because I think ever since, you know, Halloween that we hung out, I was developing feelings for him, even though it was supposed to be casual, and I know that. So, like, all I said, I messaged him the next morning, like, early in the morning before, because I really didn't sleep much at all, that I think we should end it, because I was developing feelings. And I know that's not what he wanted. I wasn't expecting him to reciprocate that in any way. Just that, like, we should end it. Because, you know, you're going to be gone. I'm really sad about that, more than I should be for something that's casual. And, you know, I wished him the best with his album and all of that. And I'll insert, again, that message that I sent to him. And I'll also insert his response to that, which was, at the time, very hurtful. I was sad to receive that, but at the end of the day, you know, it was upfront, whatever, and I probably needed that to try to move on from him. So I was just gonna leave it there. I wasn't gonna message him again. I was just gonna, okay, it was just like an experience, fun thing to happen. I enjoyed most of it, I guess, except for, you know, the fighting. But obviously I have more to talk about, so that's not where it ended. But yeah, he ended up messaging me again about a month later. This was Christmas Eve. He messaged me, and I'm not gonna insert the whole conversation. Not much happened. He wasn't actually free that day. He had his child with him, but he told me at the time that he would be free soon and he'd like to see me, and I missed him. Of course I missed him, so, you know, I didn't hold firm on my decision not to talk to him anymore, and I, you know, in retrospect, probably should have held firm, but I didn't, so, like, okay, yeah, I would like to see you, let me know when you're free, and, he wasn't free until, January 12th is when he messaged me again, asking me if I'd like to come over. And yeah, of course I wanted to come over, and of course he asked me once again, like, hey, do you know anybody that you'd want to bring? And this time, I did have somebody in mind, because I had met with the girl during the time that me and him were talking, and she seemed like somebody that possibly would be down, possibly would be interested. So I'm like, okay, I can ask her. And I did, I asked her, and he was cool this time with me, like, mentioning his name and letting her know who it was with. So, I didn't think she'd believe me just through a text, like, what's going on, but she did. She believed me, and she was interested, and she was down. And so we both agreed to go and see him that night. And let me tell you, that night went terribly, terribly, terribly wrong. Like, it went really badly. And that was the last time I ever saw him, and will be the last time I ever see him. I'm not going to ever see him again, and after I make this series of videos, I doubt he'll want to see me again. But yeah, I went over a little earlier than her, and I admittedly got way too drunk. I got very drunk, I think, because part of me really didn't want this threesome, and I was very nervous, so I overdrank, and I have apologized to both of them since then for drinking like that. But yeah, I mean, things were good for a while. Like, we were all talking, we were all having fun, and, like, things were good for most of the night, until, like, it actually started, and, I think, like, not too long into, you know, me kind of starting this or making a move, he asked me to leave. He told me that I should go, and admittedly, I snapped. Because, like, all of this, all of you asking, all of you begging, not begging, well, kind of begging, but not really, to make this happen for him, and I finally get it to happen for him, and I'm just starting, like, we're just getting going, and you want me to leave. His reason for wanting me to leave is that I was excluding him, apparently, in his eyes. I was excluding him, and I was on some kind of power trip. I don't know. I'm going to continue this in the next video.